going on, everyone? Great Talon here, and today The Prey is going to be your weekly game, movie, and TV highlights. So right off the bat this week, we're going to start with movies and TV. MoviePass has shut down again. If anybody has MoviePass, the little membership subscription service to get movies, one free movie a week, it is shut down because they're on the verge of bankruptcy. So if you haven't jumped ship on this MoviePass whole fad now, you might want to, because first of all, it was only $9.99 a month. Now it's up to like $25 a month, I think, and it's ridiculous. You can only see certain movies at certain times, and it's too much. And just jump ship now. You have been warned. The Great Talon has warned you. So, moving on. The first live-action trailer for Disney's Mulan, premiering in March of 2020, dropped. And honestly, I must say it looks good. I mean, I like Mulan. I don't love Mulan, but I like it. I enjoy the tale. And it honestly looks really, really good. It looks like Mulan. I wonder how they're gonna spin this. Wonder how they're gonna have Mushu. I wonder if he's gonna talk. I wonder if there is gonna be a Mushu. But it honestly looks like how The Last Samurai, starring Tom Cruise, should have been, in a sense. But anyway, I'm looking forward to this. I'll probably be seeing it in theaters in March, and I'll let you know my thoughts when it comes out. The Big Lebowski spinoff starring Jesus, it's called the Jesus Rolls, to arrive in theaters early 2020, starring John Turturro. I don't know if you guys are Big Lebowski fans. I am. I'm going to probably see this because this is awesome. I can't believe they're doing a spinoff with John Turturro as Jesus, called Jesus Rolls, and that's how he rolls, and we will be seeing this early 2020. Todd Phillips, the director of the upcoming Joker movie, claims that it will not follow anything of the comics and be its own original story. I'm for that. As long as that's stated and it's not trying to be like something that it's not and trying to replicate something, let it be its own tale, let it tell its own story, and I am all on board for that. Chris Rock is rebooting Saw? Chris Rock? Okay, and it's going to star Samuel L. Jackson, and it's coming out Halloween of 2020. Kay? Director John Watts wants Kraven in the next Spider-Man solo film. Yes, we have to have Kraven if we're going to have a Sinister Six film follow shortly after in a fourth or fifth movie. If we have Venom, it's going to take away from the focus of the Sinister Six. I know Sony really wants to get that Sinister Six off the ground. They really should, but at the same time, some executives at Sony want a Venom in the next movie because they want Tom Hardy to cross over. I don't really care for that too much. I'd rather see Kraven. I'd rather see the Sinister Six get up off the ground running. I want Doc Ock. I want fucking, like, I want to see that shit in motion. I really want that to happen. I really want this. So I'm with John Watts. Let's make it happen. Let's start petitioning for it now before the whole Venom snowball effect. I like Venom. I love Venom. Don't get me wrong. I enjoyed the Venom movie. I thought it was okay, but it wasn't amazing, but it was okay. But I really want to see the Sinister Six. Or Secret Wars or together. I'm really, really, really pushing for that. So let's just hope that comes to fruition. Batman Beyond Complete Series Blu-ray has potential release date for this fall. It has been actually leaked by Amazon France. And in case you guys don't know, Batman Beyond is the fucking shit, okay? Because it's awesome. It takes the story of Terry McGinnis, a young, sprouting character who's been mentored and tutored by Bruce Wayne. Actually, it turns out to be his son. Spoiler alert, at the end of the show, they reveal that. So it's like the son of Batman taking over Batman's place. And it's fucking awesome. You guys, if you haven't watched Batman Beyond, you really should. It's an amazing show. The Cuphead is being turned into an animated cartoon series on Netflix. Hell yeah! I mean, I wonder if it's going to be difficult, though. I wonder if it's going to be challenging to watch as the freaking game is to play. Because I still can't get past the second world, damn it. This is interesting, though. It actually really deserves to be its own cartoon on its own merit. I think the game is the cartoon. If you guys haven't seen Cuphead, well, look on the screen right now. Because this is Cuphead. It's its own 1930s animated series in its own merit. But more challenging than some type of foreign algebra equation. So yeah, it's really hard. I really gotta fucking beat this game. This is the only game that has eluded me. I have not beaten. This is one of the only few games I have not beat in my life, and it's gonna kill me if I don't beat it. And I will one day. One day it will be mine. Victory shall be mine. Warner Media has announced HBO Max, another alternative streaming app like HBO Go and HBO Now that will actually have DC, Cartoon Network, and Friends to stream on their original program launching in 2020. God only knows how much they're going to charge for this. They're going to have Fresh Prince of Bel-Air exclusive, Pretty Little Liars series, all the CW crap. Yeah, so it's probably going to be like fucking $20, $25 a month for all this nonsense. I hope not. I don't really care. I'm about to give it an HBO anyway, but if you guys are into this, go for it. This is the only place you're going to be able to watch Friends if you're, I love Friends, but I got a DVD, so I don't care about that. But the DC streaming is going to be on that too, so DC, like comics, it's going to be on here as well. So, yeah, that's something to be looking forward to, I guess. Mortal Kombat movie cast the deranged Joe Taslim as Sub-Zero. Now, if you're not familiar with The Raid, it's like a Chinese, I think, or Japanese movie. That's like a crazy, like, action flick, over-the-top action flick. And, yeah, it's really, really intense. And I actually have meaning to finish it these days, but it's really... A friend told me it's really good, and it's really action-packed, and as from, like, Crouching Tiger, Hidden Dragon, all the kung fu movies out there. So that's a step in the right direction. And also, on the Mortal Kombat front, the movie is being completely rated R because it has fatalities! Yes! The first Mortal Kombat movie rated R, and it will feature fatalities. Fucking A, this director is already giving me a chubby. Sherlock Holmes 3 has finally a new director, and it's moving forward with the Rocketman director. It will star Robert Downey Jr. and Jude Law. Now that Robert Downey Jr. is no longer Iron Man, he got out of that contract. He's moving along to other greener pastures, and I love the Sherlock Holmes movies. You know, they were fun, they were witty, they were charming, they had a lot of, like, mystique to them. I enjoy them, and I can't wait to dive back into those movies. Marvel Studios will reportedly announce their Phase 4 plans at Comic-Con this coming weekend. And it's going to be kickoff with their rumored to premiere The Eternals, which is going to star Millie Bobby Brown, Angelina Jolie, and... Kumail Nanjiani, and it says here Richard Madden from Game of Thrones. So you're getting Robb Stark, you're getting Eleven, you're getting Angelina Jolie, and you're getting someone else. They're going to be the Eternals. I'm not really too interested in that. I'm probably not going to see it. I don't really follow the Eternals too much, but that's going to be their Phase 4 plans, apparently, alongside of Guardians of the Galaxy 3 and Black Panther 2 and other things that are reportedly supposed to be revealed. I will cover all of Comic-Con San Diego this coming weekend, so don't you worry about that. There's a new Flintstones animated adult comedy in the works, reportedly. So it's going to be it's going to premiere on the Warner Brothers, I think, Warner Media app might be on HBO now, according to the rap. It's going to be launching next spring on the HBO Max app. So they're already got some programs, folks. So yeah, they're already gearing up. And lastly, in your TV side of the news, The Mandalorian Season 2 is currently being worked on by Jon Favreau himself. Season 1 didn't even drop yet. We're only getting one episode when it comes out. God knows what the hell's going on with this show, but Season 2 is already happening. So, yeah. And each episode I read cost $15 million to make. And that's like shit to Disney. That's like pocket change to them, which is freaking disgusting. A little new section I'm adding in my updates are the movies premiering in theaters every week. So... what is premiered on July 12th of 2019, all these movies called, first up we had Summer Night, that came out this past Friday, so also a movie called The Farewell, 21 Bridges, starring Chadwick Boseman, Black Panther himself, and J.K. Simmons, Crawl, was out this Friday. Stuber, this silly-looking Stuber movie about Uber and starring Dave Bautista as Drax. I mean, not as Drax. And Lying and Stealing, all premiered on July 12th in theaters. And finally, your 4K Blu-ray releases this past week on July 9th. Last week, excuse me. Before we jump into video game side. So Pet Sematary 2 movie collection, you get the old one and the new one that released on July 9th. Space Station, also on July 9th. Waterworld from 4K on July 9th. And The Hulk, the 2000 Ang Lee movie, released as well on July 9th. So now let's go on to the video game side of the news. Okay, first up on your PlayStation side of the news this week, one article. A free Crash Team Racing dynamic theme is now up on the PlayStation 4. In case you're wondering what it looks like, here it is. This is the dynamic theme right here. It looks pretty nifty. if I do say so myself. And yeah, it has like music running in the background too and playing of the Crash theme. So yeah, this is totally worth it. And it's free. So go Activision. Now, when you're on Nintendo side of the news this week, we have a lot of articles and a lot of news for Nintendo we have to talk about. First off, the new leaked models show the layout for Super Nintendo World coming to Universal Studios Orlando, and it looks simply nostalgic. It is ridiculous. Super Nintendo World, look at these screens right here. Let me try and blow this up a little bit. Look at this. This is like Donkey Kong Land, Mario Land. You know, it's just of your childhood as you remember it. And honestly, you know, they're all trying to do this now. Star Wars Land, Marvel Land is coming next in Disney, and now this, and God bless these these little parks. They're making me want to go back there. It's bringing a nostalgic tear to my eye. Indie game Ion Maiden is now called Ion Fury due to a lawsuit with the metal band Iron Maiden. So now they had to change their name for some reason. Called Ion Fury, and it will be coming out on the PC first in August, and then again on the Switch at a later date. So it's like a first-person shooter Duke Nukem type of game, and it looks amazing. It looks like it's going to be really nostalgic, and I can't wait to play this. I really hope that it comes on the Switch soon, because I don't have a PC hardware capable of playing this, so I really would like to play this on the Switch. It looks really, really fun. It looks like Duke Nukem and Wolfenstein put together. And Doom even. Oh, God, it looks awesome. Tetris 99, the Tetris Battle Royale game, is adding offline multiplayer soon so you can play with bots. That's something. I don't like being online all the time. And I'm sure most of you don't either. Later on this week, the NES Online, if you have Nintendo Switch Online, the app is adding Donkey Kong 3 and Wrecking Crew. Whoopity-doo! Another lackluster round of additives for the Nintendo Switch Online app that we're paying hard-earned money for, and we're not getting just dues in return. I really hope they add that Super Nintendo app, folks, because if they do, I am never leaving the house. Or maybe I will leave the house. I'll just hide and play on the go. But there's one good feature coming to the Nintendo Switch Online this week, in the 17th. It's a rewind feature. So instead of using save states, you can just simply press a button and you'll rewind the game. And yeah, and you'll just kind of just go backwards, which is kind of cool. And a lot of old school style games should have this feature. It's actually convenient in the modern day and age. Nintendo is rumored to be making subtle changes to the Nintendo Switch hardware on all future new models being made, which is going to be like a GPU update, which will improve the battery and slight performance. Nothing major, just slightly minor changes, because in light of this other little piece of news, the Nintendo Switch Lite has been announced, folks. Yes! A Nintendo Switch Lite in three colors, turquoise, yellow, and gray, has been announced. It will feature a traditional D-pad. Yes, a traditional fucking D-pad. And it will have more battery life, a slightly better processing unit. Nothing, you know, still have 720p resolution, but it's going to be about a half inch smaller screen, but it's going to be really good. Handheld only. You can't dock it and put it on TV. I play handheld 90% of the time, so this is fucking great. I'm excited over the D-pad, and it's only going to cost $200, and it's coming out September 20th, 2019. So what more do you want, folks? There's really nothing more you can ask for, unless you just ask for the Nintendo Switch Pro, which is probably coming the end of 2020, which is fine, because this is enough, and it looks like it's robust, and I'm probably going to get the turquoise one. I don't know why. It's just, it's drawing to me. I like the match. And also, there's actually another one, a Pokemon one that looks really cool too, coming out in November. That right here, it looks like it's a nice color coordinated red, blue, and gray. That's a limited edition one. And I might actually hold off for this until November, because this looks freaking awesome. Finally, Luigi's Mansion 3 has been released. It has been leaked by Amazon to add to October 4th, 2019, just in time for Halloween. So yeah, and you know what, folks? You know what? That makes three big hitters this fall for Nintendo, on top of a new console releasing, mid-cycle console thing upgrade. You're getting Legend of Zelda Link's Awakening remake, September 20th, the same day as the Nintendo Switch Lite drops. Huh? Coincidence? I think not. October 4th, Luigi's Mansion 3, and then November 15th, Pokemon Sword and Sword and Shield. So, Nintendo owns this holiday season, whether you like it or not. Very light on the Xbox side of the news this week. One article as well, just like for PlayStation. This was definitely a Nintendo week. Xbox Game Pass is adding a play later feature. So you're getting like a queue. So whatever games you want in Game Pass, you can be like, all right, I want to play Quantum Break, then Gears 4, then Halo 2, Wars 2, then Screamrite, then ReCore in that order. It will add that to your play later list. So you'll have it like a wish list queue type thing. So it's more of an organization. It's just Microsoft giving you more features, more accessibility, more options for your interface. And I applaud them at that. They're getting better. So it only makes me happy to see what Xbox Scarlett has in store in types of the organizational type of options for the system interface. Okay, got the rundown for the multi-platform side of the news. First off, starts off with Facebook looking to acquire a game studio for VR, as well as Splinter Cell VR in development. Oh no, I'm not a VR guy. I'm sorry guys out there, but you know what? I'm sorry I can't endorse this, but hey, if VR is your thing, there's a new Splinter Cell coming, I guess. The racing game Grid has been delayed officially to October 11th from its original September 10th release date, which is not too far off, but they just said they needed time for polishing it. But let them just work on this, because all these Codemasters racing games are pretty damn good, apparently. The UK, you lucky bastard, you're getting the Batman Arkham Collection for the PS4 and Xbox One all in one place, all three games, all DLCs, all skins, everything, coming September 6th. Exclusive to the UK. The Ghostbusters remastered game is exclusive to GameStop? Why though? Just tell me why. Doesn't make any damn sense. It's coming out this October, I think, but why? Why do I have to get a physical copy at GameStop? The Satan's asshole. I do not want to go there. I do not want to dig around in Satan's asshole. It is not for me. I used to work for these cretins. I don't want to go back there for this physical copy. And I don't want to get a digital copy either. So I guess I'm going to have to make someone or grin and bear to go into a GameStop to get a physical copy of this, because this game is awesome. I really need to play this game again, especially in HD. Dual hero Metroidvania game called OutBuddies has been announced for the PS4, Xbox One, Switch, and PC, due out in 2020. It can be a co-op based Metroidvania game, or you can play it solo, I believe. So it looks really cool. I'm probably going to check this out when it comes out on the Switch. This looks like all these 2D Metroidvania games I'm getting for the Switch, because it just screams out, play me on the Switch. So this is due out in 2020. It looks like it's shaping up to be a pretty cool game. And I'll let you know how this is when it comes out. Amazon Game Studios has announced a free-to-play, fee-to-pay Lord of the Rings MMO for the consoles and PC. No release date has been announced, but it's going to be, it takes place in the Lord of the Rings lore and within the trilogy, and it's going to be an MMO. So I guess it's trying to take on World of Warcraft. Good luck with that. A new Super Monkey Ball has been raided in Taiwan. Apparently Sega has been flirting with for the Switch and PS4 and PC. They've been flirting with the idea of a new Super Monkey Ball video game. And Super Monkey Ball was pretty fun. I don't know if you guys ever played it. It was like a, you know, it had like a little, it was like a platforming type of, I guess you could say, Sonic-like game. I'm not sure how to describe Super Monkey Ball. Or like, it was weird, but it was fun. It was like a cross between like a, it was definitely a platformer, if I could say that much. But yeah, and some of it had like racing elements, fighting elements. I would like to see where they go with this, if they're actually going to release a new Super Monkey Ball, because Sega's been flirting with new revamping all old franchises. So I would like to see a Super Monkey Ball racing game. That would be pretty fun. Or even a platformer. Hey, anything. Anything is good at this point. The Dark Pictures Man of Medan, the new Supermassive games coming out this August, will have a co-op multiplayer mode, which is vastly interesting. So you can pretty much play this with a friend, with a buddy, with anybody, and you know, and it looks fucking terrifying, this game. So I'm very happy to see you can play with a friend. I know one of my friends is definitely going to be playing this with me when it comes out. So I'm probably going to be getting this first day it comes out, and I'm going to be in horror. And luckily I won't be alone, because I'll have a friend to play with, and you will too, if you choose to. A TurboGrafx-16 Mini has been announced, the PC engine with over 50 games. Because why not, folks? Because why not? It's coming March 2020, March 19, 2020 for $100. Here it is. I'll link this in the description if you want to check out the games for it. Everybody's trying to jump on board this mini console generation era now, because, you know, nostalgia always wins. It's like sex, people. Sex always sells. Nostalgia will always sell. That is a fucking fact. So I'll link this in the description for you to check out the games. If you like a TurboGrafx-16, you can go ahead and check it out. And finally, the co-creator of the Halo series is coming out with a new first-person shooter sci-fi game called Disintegration. It will be revealed at Gamescom next month in August, which I will be covering as well, and gameplay will be shown there. So unfortunately, the only thing that was shown was a brief teaser here with just like some type of like cinematography or CG or whatever. But and the full reveal will be coming on August, I think, 20th. Next month at Gamescom. So I'll be covering that as it develops. Now we have your video game releases of this week. First, on Nintendo Switch, we have an adult-themed game called Senran Kagura. Looks like an adult-themed pinball, erotic pinball game. So that was out on July 9th on Nintendo Switch. On July 9th, also saw the release of another Japanese game called Umahara Kawase Fresh. Another little platforming game, by the looks of it, a side-scrolling one at that. On iOS and Android, on July 10th, saw the release of Dr. Mario World for the, like I said, the iOS and the Android mobile game. So it's like Tetris, but Mario style, baby. So if you're into this and need a quick minute and you're waiting in the doctor's office or you're waiting to, you know, in line or something, and you need something to play real quick, play some Dr. Mario, folks. Just for the love of God, don't pay them to play it. Just play it. On July 11th, so on PS4, PC, Switch, and Xbox One, saw the release of the classic, nostalgic take on the run-and-gun franchise of the 8-bit and 16-bit past called Blazing Chrome, two-player co-op action run-and-gun game. I am going to buy this immediately because I love action junkie games like this. So I will let you know how I will be reviewing this too, so don't you worry, I will be, and this game looks amazing. Another game called Tiny Metal Full Metal Rumble released on the PC and the Switch on July 11th, and it looks like a kind of like a Lego action figure type of like a combat game. I don't know if it's like an RTS or something like that, but it looks like a little cute little quirky robot mech type action, or maybe it's a strategy game. I'm not even sure. Actually, I think it's an Advanced Wars style. Yeah, it's like Advanced Wars. It's like a grid-based battle game, kind of like an XCOM type thing. So, yeah, that's out July 11th. On the PC on July 11th, saw the release of Earth Defense Force 5, the fifth installment to the crazy over-the-top action alien eviscerating game. So it looks like a really ridiculous game. You know what it reminds me of? It reminds me of that game. What the hell was it? I think it was called like Prototype or something that was ridiculously over the top like that. On July 11th, saw the release of Cyveriar Delta for the PS4 and the Nintendo Switch, which looks like a kind of like a Ikaruga type game almost, or a like a Galaga type thing, I believe. The PS4 and the Switch saw the release of Dragon Quest Builders 2 on July 12th, which was this past Friday. So this game is like a grid battle system, I think, as well, and a building game too. So you can like a Minecraft meets like kind of like that XCOM or Mario Rabbids thing, it looks like, if I'm not mistaken. Looks pretty cute. It's pretty doable. It looks pretty playable. Well, it might be even action, attack, and slash as well. I'm not too familiar with the Dragon Quest series, as you can tell, but it's been around for a while and has a huge following, so if you're interested in this, go for it. I myself will be checking out Dragon Quest XI on the Switch when it comes out this fall. I'll let you know what I think of that. And finally, on July 12th, saw the release of God Eater 3 for the Nintendo Switch. It's been ported, and it's fully, you know, handheld and whatnot. I actually have this for the PS4. It's pretty fun. It's more fun with a buddy. And it's just ridiculous. It's like Monster Hunter. It's just, you're just hunting down monsters and slaying them. And it's pretty damn fun. So with that being said, I'm going to bring you over to my Switch eShop releases for this past week in North America, as well as Europe as well. And of course, the Switch Summer Sale, which discounts 193 Nintendo Switch, Wii U, and 3DS games. So With that being said, I am done. I'm taking up enough of your time. Thanks for stopping by. Don't forget to hit that like and subscribe button. It helps me out a lot tremendously. Drop a comment below. Let's get the discussion started. What are you looking? Are you looking forward to the Nintendo Switch Lite? I know I am. I'm going to be pre-ordering that as soon as humanly possible. So you guys have a great day, night, and life. Thanks for stopping by as always. I love you guys, and we'll catch you on the next one. And thank you, as always, for stopping by.